The market's hitting all-time highs, but while that's going on, the VIX is well off the lows and is almost green on the day. What the heck is going on right now? Watch this video for a little bit more insight into what the volatility market's doing right now. Hey, this is Steve Place from investingwithoptions.com, where we teach people just like you how to be great option traders. And today we're going to look at the interplay between the VIX and the S&P 500 market. So we're hitting all-time highs, and it's been a pretty strong run over the past few days. If we take a look at the Bollinger Band envelope, you can see that we've now got two days in a row above the second standard deviation Bollinger Band. We had this breakaway gap right here, so things are looking really strong. We're starting to see some parabolic movement in some large cap stocks. You know, if you look at pot stocks, they're on a really strong tear. So overall, it's a kind of risk on environment. Normally, you would expect when the market hits all-time highs that the VIX would be at relative lows. Yet here we are starting green. Now, if you're looking for some kind of a market top, you are probably thinking, oh, this obviously means the smart money is piling into insurance and we're obviously going to roll over and crash. Well, if you think like that, you've probably been thinking that for months anyways. So it doesn't really matter what kind of evidence you need. You're going to find the evidence to support some kind of a strong move to the downside. Here's what I think. The VIX is a fear indicator, yet sometimes the fear is not just to the downside. Sometimes the fear is to the upside. Remember, when the VIX gets measured, it's puts and calls. We look at the implied volatility of puts and calls. Okay, so what I've done is I went back and I said, all right, when the VIX was right around 10 right here, you know, what kind of expected move was being priced into the market? And so what I do right here is I go out and I say, all right, you know, back on August 7th right here, I go out to the option board that's about 30 days out, and I said, what's the 15 delta call strike and what's the 15 delta put strike? Because the market prices in something that looks a little bit like this, right? And 15 delta, you know, that's a nice magical number that I like to look at because I use it for iron condors and some other trading things. So what tends to happen is, you know, you go 30 days out and there's an expected percentage move, you know, that we see, and then we look at the upside. Now, the distance for the 15 delta call is always going to be less than the distance for the 15 delta put, and that's because of option skew. People are always going to be concerned about movement to the downside. Okay, it's just always going to be baked in there because most people are scared about the downside. Yet you have these market makers that not only care about downside risk, but what if we see a melt up? So what I did after comparing where the strikes are, and let's see the strikes, I actually managed to line this up really, really well. The actual pricing was 29.25 right here. And then to the downside was 27.65. So right around here. So what we're going to do is we're going to redraw this and say, all right, this is kind of what the market was expecting, 27.65. Okay. Now, what I can do is look at the current option pricing. We're going to change this to this nice light blue and say, all right, what kind of expectation are we seeing right now? And then what we can do is we can draw out a new, you know, expectation. And what we can do here is compare the percentages both to the upside and downside. Now, this isn't going to be super, super precise. It's a little quick hack. But what we can see is that on August 7th, the S&P 500 was currently trading at about 2860. The 15 delta put was at 2765. So that was about 3.33% to the downside. Okay, that was the pricing of 15 delta. Remember, delta is always going to be a function of odds. They're always going to be interplayed like that. So a 15 delta option means that's what the option market is pricing in for about a 15% chance that we're going to see that option in the money into expiration. Okay, delta and odds are always going to be tied together. To the upside, we're seeing 29.25 back on August 7th, so about a 2.33% upside expectation in terms of those odds. Now, let's go to today. We're currently trading right around 2,900. The 15 delta put is at 27.95. That's 3.69. Okay, that is higher than 3.36. And then if you look at the 15 delta call, and this is where it gets really interesting, and I think that this is why the VIX continues to stay bid, 29.75, which is 2.59%. So that's higher than 2.29%. All right, so here's what's going on. Back, let's see if I can visualize this a little bit better. Okay, back here, we had a certain expectation of pricing 30 days out. Okay, and then right now, we have a certain expectation of pricing 30 days out. And the width of this expectation has increased both to the upside and downside. Market makers have widened out the market. There are not a lot of aggressive option sellers. There's not a lot of aggressive option shorts. Now, you have one reason to the downside, and that is because everyone remembers what happened in February. And there are not a lot of retail volatility shorts anymore, because if you were a retail trader buying volatility short exposure, you were buying XIV, and XIV got blown out. SVXY got blown out, right? So that's one of the reasons I think that there is an expectation or an increased expectation of downside risk. On top of that, we're also concerned about the melt up. I know I'm concerned about the melt up because if I put on iron condors, any sort of income trade that ends up being net short as the market rallies, I get smoked, right? So market makers and option traders are saying, you know, we're hitting all-time highs right here, and we're kind of in a news vacuum, and it's possible that we just continue to trend higher and higher up to 3,000 without any kind of pullback, similar to what we saw in December and January. So what's going on here? There's not a lot of people selling calls because nobody wants to get run over into that melt up. So you have this dynamic where the supply is reduced. All right, there's not a lot of people selling puts. There's not a lot of people selling calls. There's a little bit more hedging going on. The expectation of risk is continuing to expand into all-time highs, which is the really weird thing. There's fear both to the downside and the upside. All right, so this is kind of one of those weird sweet spots where you have the market that's a little bit overbought right now and options are not getting aggressively short vol. Iron condors right here are probably a good bet. We've already put some on for Income Lab subscribers. If you want to see more about that, you can sign up for an Iron Condor toolkit below this video, and that'll get you access to a trial offer for Income Lab. But yeah, I think right now iron condors are a pretty good bet because we are not seeing the same kind of volatility selling like we did at the beginning of the year. People are worried about the downside and the upside. And that's the weird thing. And that's where I think that the edge is right now, because option skew is high, implied volatility is still high relative to actual volatility. And as long as you manage your risk well in these iron condor trades, it should be a really, really good setup right here. If you want more of these videos, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can get access to the Iron Condor Toolkit. If you're on YouTube, get it in the description. If you're on investingwithoptions.com, there's going to be an opt-in box below this video. And have a great day.